so we just took a quick walk down the road here, quick drive down the road here, got our stuff, and we're checking into this guest house that our buddy Tony has recommended for us. He's got a nice little patio bar slash hookah lounge slash chill spot, and we'll be staying over here. So our man Tony again hooking us up as always. You're the man. So we're up on the third floor. All right guys, so here we are on the third floor of the guest house we're staying at, which is 450,000 Lebanese lira. We've got Fuad and I staying in this room. That's my bed, that's his. And if we had another friend come with us, we'd have another bed for them. So the nice part is we're right next to that shop, Tony's shop or a cafe, restaurant, bar, that is just right over there.
It's called Le Pergola.
Le Pergola, and he's gonna be having a party tonight. So works out that we're just a few steps away. Now, after getting checked in, it's time to go find Darius. We may not actually go searching for him. We're gonna ask the villagers up top if they know whether or not he's accepting guests today. We're not gonna do the hike again just to do it to find him. If they say he's not accepting visitors, then we'll have to come back in a couple weeks. But yalla, bro.
To the hermit.
To the hermit.
To the hermit.
Let's go, yalla, bro.
We need an inspiration.
Exactly, let's do it. So we just got over here to Hawa, which is the top of the mountain where we're going to potentially hike down. Fuad and I are gonna try and find a local we can ask. Well, all right, so we have people right here behind that we're gonna ask to see if Darius is how they call him here. Darius Escobar is accepting people. Oh, just kidding. Bunch of people in a pool hanging out. So we're gonna go a little further down and see if we can find someone. It's a beautiful drive coming down here though.
Hello?
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
كيفك؟ سؤال الناسك عم بيستقبل العالم اليوم؟
لا ما عم بستقبل
بالمرة. اوكي. ميرسي كثير. سوري عذبناك كلك ذوق.
مش مفتوح
اذا بتكون. اوكي. ثانك يو. كلك ذوق.
ثانك يو. So what's the verdict, bro?
He's not like in he's not inviting people or like he's not seeing people these days. I think Joe mentioned that, you know, the COVID and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, like, because like hermits like live alone,
yeah,
away from society, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Well guys, it's a bummer. Probably quite unlikely that we're gonna be going down there today. I think that means we're gonna be heading over to our next thing to do, which is to rent some buggies and go cruising up near the Cedars. So let's head on over that way.
What do you wanna do? You wanna go up today?
Yeah,
we're yeah, yalla.
Yep.
Okay, wait for me there. Yo, 2 minutes. I'm just packing up and I'm coming out.
Yalla, see ya.
Okay.
Bye.
Okay.
So when the corona started, the COVID, the pandemic outbreak, he stopped like seeing people.
Oh, so like over a year ago then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Merci, tante. كلك ذوق.
Merci.
Thank you.
Yeah, so we went and asked another set of locals just on our way out, just to kind of get a better idea, because if 2 days in a row he wasn't seeing visitors, we were like, okay, I wonder what's going on. And so it sounds like since the pandemic started, he's no longer seeing visitors just for the risks of COVID-19. So that's a huge bummer. I guess we won't go searching for him now or in a couple weeks, but I guess it was still cool that we were within just a couple meters of him yesterday. We heard him like cough inside or make some noise or something. We're assuming that's him because that was his house and or his cave, so.
And there was the smell of Bakhur, he was like praying.
Yeah, he was praying, so yeah, we were close to him. So that just means we'll have to come back at some point someday and try for it again. Still a fun adventure to try and find him. But yeah, now we're gonna head back into town. We're gonna meet Tony, who is the Bishare legend, the most hospitable guy here, up there tied with his brother Joe. He's gonna help hook us up with a good price on getting buggies. Like a year ago, 2 years ago, a buggy would cost about $1 per minute. Now with the currency crisis, we were quoted roughly $35 for 1 hour, whereas before it'd be $60 an hour. So obviously coming here with dollars, it makes it a bit more affordable for us right now, and I'm excited to show you guys that. We're gonna go check out up in the mountains near the Cedars. We're gonna do cruising for about 2 hours total, I think, and then later on in the evening we're gonna go to a Lebanese party at Tony's place. That it's gonna be really fun. Yalla Bina, we'll see you over there. All right, we just made it over to La Pergola. This is where the party's gonna be tonight. As you can see, yeah, beautiful. They're starting to get set up. Got the speakers there. We've got seating. There's gonna be performers, singers, They've got a menu of drinks, they've got food, a whole bunch of stuff here.
Like shisha.
Yeah, they have shisha if you're into that. So a lot of different options. So it's gonna be a big party tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah, if Tony's the host, you know it's gonna be a good time.
You're gonna see how we party.
Exactly, up in Bishare.
In Bishare.
Yeah, there's a special accent to say it up here, right? Like Bishare.
Yeah.
So what are we doing for juice here?
Fresh pineapple juice.
Oh, fresh pineapple juice. I tell you, Tony hooks it up every day, all the time. You guys better see him when you come up here.
Jeez. Café Trottoir is a must.
Yeah, oh yeah. You guys saw that in the other video.
It's easy to find the Café Trottoir. It's like in downtown Charre, main road, there to find it.
Exactly. We had no idea about Café Trottoir. We didn't know too much about Bichardet. Well, I didn't. We just randomly stopped for a coffee. And then that's how we met Tony. So that just shows how hospitable the people up here in Bishare are.
You won the lotto.
Yeah, we won the lotto, exactly.
Yeah. Here we go.
Cheers. Thank
cheers.
You, Tony.
Fresh.
That is refreshing in that Bishare heat. Mm-mm-mm. All right, after a nice little pineapple juice pit stop over at Tony's La Pergola, it's now time to head over to the ATVs. So we're going to do a quick 10-12 minute cruise over and we will be there. As you can see, the interesting part about Lebanon is we're pulling up on tanks right now. You got them in the road, which doesn't necessarily mean there's a concern, but it's, you know, at first glance you're like, whoa, there's tanks in the road, like what are these for? But it's just they have them sitting in all the villages and all the cities. There's military just for protection in case something did happen, but it seems like it's unlikely that things will happen. All right, it looks like we're arriving at the spot here. There's our Habibi right there. Sabajo.
Sharbel? Kefak.
Kefak. All right, so we're arriving at the spot here where we're gonna be picking them up, called JCC. They've got quads or ATVs and they have buggies. We're going to the buggy because I want the roll cage.
Yep.
For a couple different reasons. And ATVs are just a bit more dangerous. You know, the reality in Lebanon is you gotta be a little safer while you're here right now because there's certain medical supplies that there's a shortage right now with the economic issues and the issues going on in the country. So I figured right now it's better to play it a little safer if we're gonna do this. So yalla, let's go. See what we can get it for. I think we're gonna get it for $35 a day, but we'll see what the final price is. Kifak, Habibi.
Buggy. She roll cage.
Do you think this is good?
I think, yeah. This one right over there?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one looks fast and fun.
Yep. There's another one with the roof on top.
For the same price?
700k an hour. Which one do you prefer?
The one with the roof, so we have sun coverage.
Okay, so how many? Wanna
just
go for
2 hours, yeah.
Yeah, okay, we'll do for 2 hours, 1,400,000.
All right, 1,400,000. So this is our baby right here. Is this a fast one?
Yeah, I think it's fast. I think it's 800.
Yeah,
la foutre
l'endemain.
We
need to
enter. Right, we gotta sign it. After you, bro.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Gotta sign the life away here, bro.
And you need to sign also.
Yeah, sweet.
Okay, so Max.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we got 1.4 mil for it.
Sweet.
All right, so Fouad's number one driver to start out.
I don't want to take vitesse blanket.
Okay.
Benzin
or frame? Okay.
What's that? The frame and all.
Oh yeah, engines have been started.
Oh, you should put the seat belts.
There we go. Now I feel a little bit safer with Fouad driving. You ever driven one of these, bro?
No.
Oh. Never driven one. Well, full speed ahead, bro.
Let's go.
Let's get it.
Yalla.
Yalla.
Here we go! Yalla! Oh yeah, we're coming up on the cedars! Yep!
Got the cedars right up there!
These are the skiing poles!
You can take the ski in the winter.
Yeah,
that's how you get up.
Hook. That's a small hook.
It's a tiny one.
Yeah, the big mountains are up there to go skiing over there.
Nice. So up there is where they're normally skiing in the winter?
Yeah, you can see the poles at the station over there where they like take you through like after those mountains, like upper mountains where you go skiing.
Nice.
Yeah, it's really dope.
Sounds dope, bro.
Yeah, that's dope, bro.
All right, so we're coming up on a Lebanese Army checkpoint. This is my first time openly filming without
Ja, dicke Lauf hier.
Keep on.
Yeah, Max, Mac now is Lebanese.
So we just took a roughly 20-minute cruise up to the top of the mountains here. The amazing part is you can see the mountains, you can see all of Beshare, some of the other villages, the entire valley. I don't know how much you guys can see it from the GoPro, but once I get the drone up, you'll be able to see all of it. And we can see Baalbek over there?
Yeah, up there, down there.
His name is Sherbel.
Sherbel, Mac, nice to meet you. So he's a local, he knows all the best spots. He's gonna be taking us up through the mountains. We're gonna do a little off-roading. We're gonna show you guys this area, but for now, let's get the drone up. Doesn't always show it. Oh wow, we got a couple of people crossing the road. By people, I mean sheep. Hello, salam alaikum, marhaba, marhaba amigo. And yeah, so right now over there is Baalbek Plains. What else can you see down there?
Well, the village under us, it's visible. Yeah, it's called
Aineto. Yeah, you probably can't see it in the GoPro, but basically there's so much you can see when you take the ATV, UTV, buggy cruise way up here into the mountains. So now we're gonna do a little off-roading. So we're heading down to a lake right down there. You probably can't see it, but you will soon. Backpack, because now I can block all the dust. So we have just switched over to off-roading. We got some other guests here. Marhaba!
Hello!
Hey, marhaba!
Hello!
All right, we just made a stop over here. And the nice part is you can see a beautiful view of the cedars. Make sure if you guys haven't seen the other video, the earlier vlog from here in Beshare, we actually explore the cedars, the national emblem of all of Lebanon. So it's a beautiful place to see. This is one of two, right? One of two like areas where the cedars like are in a huge quantity, because there's one other part in Lebanon, right?
That's the main cedars location, but other forests are like kind of random forests, but that's the main cedars forest here. And Beshare the cedars. And he said that Jesus Christ passed through here and prayed inside. You remember last time when there was a mass over there? It's like a memorial or like a day where Jesus Christ was there and praying to God and communicating to God in the cedars forest.
We as well driving this.
Oh yeah, guys, we got a new driver in place. We are cruising along the edge of a mountain right now. Quad's a little scared. I don't think he has any idea that I've driven these in so many countries. Knock on wood, things can still happen. But I'm somewhat of an experienced driver. And now we're cruising over to this really beautiful lake that's been recommended to us by Tony's brother Joe. And of course, our man, Charbel. And yeah, it's a really beautiful ride. There's like some very modern houses along the way in here that we passed a bit. We didn't have the GoPro out because it was a bit dusty. And yeah, now it's really nice cruise right along the ridge here down into the valley. Oh yeah, guys, I'll tell you, you'll want to bring a bandana or goggles because it gets a little dusty when you're driving behind the guy. Full speed ahead! Opa! being a passenger for your first time in like 3 weeks?
It's really good. It's fun.
Oh, these are two apples. Delicious apple.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Sharma, for the apples.
Sharma, did you steal these?
No, it's not stealing. This is like organic apple. There's no like chemical stuff in it.
You sure?
Yeah, yeah. Because Sharre, the area of Sharre is like the best place where you can grow apples.
Yum.
Yeah, it's really good. Oh, I guess
that's the lake.
That's the lake that we're talking about.
Can we swim in here?
No, there was like a small billboard saying swimming is prohibited on the lake.
That's a bummer.
Yeah.
That would have been fun.
Sure, you are enjoying the apple.
Oh, yeah. That's a Lebanese apple. It's only made in one place in the world, in Lebanon. Turquoise water. Nice little view. Would be great to take a little jump in right now. It's a bit warm out here. But we'll find some other swimming places in another video, guys. So we just got to the lake here.
It's called the Bahirat Ba'kafra. It's like the lake of Ba'kafra.
So, speaking of swimming, don't even try and sneak in here because actually I guess it's a bit of a sinkhole. So if you go in there, you'll disappear and never come back. So that makes sense why swimming is prohibited. Let's go ahead and maybe get the drone up. We can see what this place looks like from above. Fuad bringing us back home, and that pretty much is gonna wrap up our time out here cruising. He's going full Bacharo. That's how one of the dialects says Bashare.
Bashoroi.
Bashoroi.
Yeah, he was saying it like that.
Bashoroi. And it's, yeah, it's definitely a dusty ride. I think everything I have is covered in lots of dust. You can probably even see it on the sunglasses. But it's a nice cruise out here in the mountains. It's cool going off road because you get to, like, feel like you're in it now. So we're cruising through Bashare right now, and there's some pretty nice accommodations. Like, look at this log cabin here, absolutely stunning, with like the rock architecture built into there. So cool. We've got a lot of accommodations for places to stay out like this that can range from budget friendly, or that's probably it, who knows, like a lot of money per night to stay at. So you really get multiple options if you're more of a budget traveler, luxury traveler. But there's a lot to do in this town. Not as much, obviously, nightlife. Not obviously, because you guys might not know about it, but there is a nightlife here. But it's a super cool town otherwise. All right, we just finished up a nice 2-hour cruise. I am pretty dusty, but I am full of energy because our man Charbel hooked us up. Hey, thank you, brother.
Welcome.
Great time. What'd you think?
Yeah, it was awesome.
Beautiful views, great time, bunch of different spots we were able to see. I definitely feel like I've seen pretty much all of Bashare now, or some of the highlighted parts for sure. So that was great to be able to really get out there, explore some of the mountains without hiking, because the hiking was fun yesterday, but sometimes it gets a little warm to hike, but I would still recommend doing the hiking. So now that we finished that nice cruise here out in the mountains, we're gonna head back over, probably clean up and grab something to eat.
Yalla bina.
Yalla bina.
Yep, let's go.
We finished off the evening heading over to a village nearby Bashare known as Hasron. In Hasron, there are a lot more restaurants and places to eat, as well as go out and party late into the night, unlike in Bashare. After some food, we made our way back into Bashare to visit our friend Tony for his birthday party.
We're checking out Tony's party, and it is awesome. It's basically like a Bashare party. There's not a lot of parties here, so it's pretty lit.
We had a lot of fun over here, meeting his friends, enjoying some drinks, and learning some Lebanese Arab dance moves.
They all just invited me up just by myself. I feel like Fuad told them, but he swears he didn't. So they went on the microphone and yelled Max and had me come up and dance like to Arabic music, Lebanese Arabic music that I have no idea how to do it to. But it was fun. It was an experience. My dance moves were not on point, but it was a good time.
How you feeling, bro?
Yeah, I'm good, bro. Vodka's really good.
Vodka's great.
Yeah, man.
And that is where I will end this video today, guys. I really hope you have enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure to hit that subscribe button below and smash that like button. And I will see you guys in the next video.